Hello everyone, today we are going to learn this cute Dwendwen chicken. Wrap yarn around the little finger, around the index finger, and then around the middle finger to make a ring. Use your thumb press it. Insert the hook. Wrap the yarn around the hook. Grab the yarn through the loop, this called a yarn over. Yarn over. Pull through the loop, that is a chain stitch. Let's do it again. Wrap the yarn around the finger. Insert the hook. Wrap the yarn around the hook. Grab the yarn through the loop, this called a yarn over. Yarn over. Pull through the loop. That is a chain stitch. Now we start to learn the first round of the body. Insert the hook. Yarn over. Then yarn over to grab the yarn through the loop on the hook. That call a single crochet. The V shape called a stitch. One stitch includes two loops. Put the marker clasp at the first stitch. Beginners need marker clasp, which allow us to clearly see which stitch is the first one to avoid confusion. And then keep doing 5 single crochet in the ring. Yarn over. Through 2 loops. To make another single crochet. Three. Four. Five. Six. These V shape are 6 stitches. One single crochet create 1 V stitch. Place marker at the last stitch. It is best for beginners to put a marker on both the first and last stitches. After we finishing 6 single crochet, we pull the beginning tail gently to close the ring. Now we have made a magic ring. Every time we finish a round, we should do a slip stitch at the first stitch and do a chain stitch to start the next round. This is the first stitch we've made. Take out the marker. Insert hook into the first stitch. Yarn over through the loop. That called a slip stitch, make a slip stitch to end the first round. And we do a chain stitch to start next round. Round 2 we do 6 increase crochet, means every stitch do 2 single crochet. Insert the hook into the first stitch. It's the stitch we made the slip stitch, don't miss the first stitch, yarn over. Yarn over hook, pull through 2 loops. Put the marker at first stitch. Do it again at the same stitch. This called an increase stitch. Next stitch also do 2 single crochet. Every stitch do 2 single crochet, repeat to finish this round. Don't forget to do a slip stitch at the first stitch, and do a chain stitch to start the next round. Round 3, we do a single crochet, an increase crochet, repeat 6 times. Insert the hook into the first stitch, yarn over. Over again, through the loop. It's the first single crochet. And we do 2 single crochet in the next stitch. And do a single crochet and increase crochet. Repeat to finish this round. Round 4, we do a single crochet. An increase crochet. A single crochet. Single, increase, single. That's a group. Repeat 6 times to finish this round. Round 5 we do 24 single crochet. Now we adjust it, turn it over. This is the right side, circle by circle. This is the wrong side. The pattern is different. We should always keep the right side facing ourselves. Round 6 we do 3 single crochets, an increase crochet. Repeat 6 times. Don't forget to do a slip stitch at the first stitch, and do a chain stitch to start the next round. Round 7, we do 30 single crochets. Round 8. We do 2 single and increase 2 single. Repeat 6 times, totally 36 stitches. This is one group. Two single. An increase makes two stitches. Two single. Repeat 6 times to finish this round. Round 9. We do 36 single crochets. Round 10. We do 5 single, 1 increase. Repeat 6 times, totally 42 single crochets. This is one group. 5 single makes 5 stitches. 1 increase makes 2 stitches. Repeat 6 times to finish this round. Round 11, we do 42 single crochets. Round 12, we do 5 single, 1 increase, repeat 7 times, totally 49 single crochets. Five single makes 5 stitches, 1 increase makes 2 stitches, this is 1 group. We need to do 7 group to finish this round. round 13, we do 49 single crochets. Round 14. We do 3 single, 1 increase, 3 single, repeat 7 times, totally 56 single crochets. This is one group. 3 single makes 3 stitches, 1 increase makes 2 stitches, and 3 single. We need to do 7 group to finish this round. Round 15 to round 21 are knitted in the same way, 56 single crochets. The video is fast forwarded. Remember to finish it yourself. At first, it might be difficult, but you just need to take your time learning how to do the stitches and keep practicing. So your hands get used to the movements and it'll become easier and you'll get better and better. How to check how many round we hooked. From the beginning circle, count upwards. Here's 15 rounds, and the round 16 is about to begin. Now, we have done the round 21. Don't forget to do a slip stitch at the first stitch, and do a chain stitch to start the next round. Round 22, we do 3 single, 1 decrease, 3 single, repeat 7 times, totally 49 single crochets. First, making 3 single crochets. Then insert hook into the next stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop. Insert hook into next stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop. Here's 3 loops on hook. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops on the hook. That's called a decrease stitch. Then make 3 single crochets. This is 1 group. We need to do 7 group to finish this round. Round 23, we do 5 single, 1 decrease, repeat 7 times, totally 42 single crochets. First, making 5 single crochets. Then insert hook into the next stitch, yarn over, and pull up a loop. Insert hook into next stitch, yarn over, and pull up a loop. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops on the hook. To make a decrease stitch, this is 1 group. We need to do more 6 group to finish this round. Round 24. We do 5 single, 1 decrease. Repeat 6 times, totally 42 single crochets. Round 25. We do 2 single, 1 decrease, 2 single. Repeat 6 times, totally 30 single crochets. Round 26. We do 3 single, 1 decrease. Repeat 6 times, totally 24 single crochets. Round 27. We do 2 single, 1 decrease. Repeat 6 times, totally 18 single crochets. At the end of round 27, pull a long tail, stuffing the body with fiberfill. Do not overstuff. Fiberfill should not show between stitches. The last round of body. We do 1 single, 1 decrease. Repeat 6 times, totally 12 single crochets. Don't forget the slip stitch and chain stitch. At the end of the last round, make a slip stitch. And here's 12 stitches. We can count if we got it right. Or just redo the stitches. Pull a long tail. Get your scissors and cut it. Pull out the tail. Take the needle with a wide opening. So just put the yarn and pull. And there's two loops with a V-stitch. The outer one is front loop. The inner one is back loop. We only need to insert into the back loop. From the last stitch. One by one. Pull the yarn tail gently to close ring. And we can sew more stitches to close the ring. At the end, hide the yarn into the body. Round one of the wing. Make a slip ring, a chain stitch, 5 single crochet in the ring. Pull bag tail gently to close ring. Make a slip stitch to end the round. And make a chain stitch to start the next round. Round 2. We do 1 single, 2 increase, 2 single. Totally 7 stitches. Round 3. We do 2 single, 1 increase, 1 single, 1 increase, 2 single. Totally 9 stitches. Round 4. We do 9 single crochets. Round 5. We start to decrease the stitches. 2 single, 1 decrease, 1 single, 1 decrease, 2 single. Totally 7 stitches. Make two wings and sew them to the body with a sewing needle. On the 10th row of stitches, counting from top to bottom. With orange yarn, make 6 chain stitches, form the body directly. Make a slip stitch in the second chain stitch from hook. Only insert the hook in the back loop and same as below. And make a slip stitch in the next stitch. chain 2. Slip stitch in the second stitch from hook. Chain 2 again. Slip stitch in the second stitch from hook. And back to the loop that last slip stitch we've made before. Make 3 slip stitches. And slip stitch in the body stitch beside, cut the yarn and hide. Make a slip ring to start the eye. Chain 1. And make 4 single crochets in the ring. Round 2, we make 8 increase crochet. Totally 8 stitches. round 3, we make 8 single crochets. Make a slip stitch to finish the round 3. Pull the tail and cut. Use hook to grab the tail into the wrong side. And tie knot. Make a slip knot to start the mouth. Wrap the yarn. Make a ring and hold it. Insert the hook. Yarn over. Loose the tail and pull tightly. That's slip knot. And chain 2. Make slip stitch in the second. Then chain 3. Back to the second from the hook. Make a single crochet. Another single crochet in the next. And pull the yarn cut off. Fold in half and tie knots. Use the melt glue to glue white eyes. To the body. The top of the mouth is short. The bottom is long. Find the position to stick to the body. And then glue the black eyes to the white. Insert the hook to the middle of round one. Chain 4 from the body. Back to the third chain stitch from hook to make a half double crochet. How to do a half double crochet. First, yarn over. Insert to the stitch. Yarn over and pull. Here's 3 loops on the hook. Yarn over. Pull through all 3 loops. Then make a single crochet in the next stitch. Make a slip stitch beside. Chain 6. Back to the fourth chain stitch from the hook to make 2 double crochets. How to make a double crochet? First, yarn over. Insert hook. Yarn over. Here's 3 loops on the hook. Yarn over, pull through the first 2 loops. Yarn over again, pull through last 2 loops. Make a double crochet in the next stitch again. Make a single crochet in the last chain stitch. Make a slip stitch behind the body. hold the tail and cut. Knot and hide the yarn.